오늘은 부르짖을 때 귀가 살아난다.
Today's topic is that when you cry out, you will get bothered. I'm going to deliver God's message this topic. What is the characteristic of the living? The word makes you become dumb. We having this service on the first week of a new year, the word makes you become dumb. However, we must get further. From today's verses, Psalms 3, verse 1 to 2, O Lord, how many are my chosen? How many rise up against me? Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. David was in trouble. He fled from his son Absalom. David got troubles from his life. Like him, we face our troubles. However, we must get bothered. To describe his situation, he mentions the specific word of many. It appears three times in two verses. David mentions many enemies in his life. So, it describes that David might get down. Our God created humans with the dust of the ground. The last thing he had done is that God breathed into human. From the verse of English, breathing is called as spirit. From the versions of Hebrews, it is called as uhak, which is kind of an echoic sound. I think the Origins Bible describes like uhak, which too describes breathing. Our God created humans with breathing, so we need to get bothered. When you cry out, you will become stronger. However, the evils attempts us not to rise up. So, the evils attempts us to join. Some people make the comparisons between humans, and they try to compare with their physical appearances. So, they like to make judgments about their appearances, and also they like to make people get down. I talked about this situation before. I'll give you one example. They are a husband and a wife, both of them smart, and also they are graduates from the good university. When the husband had meetings with his school juniors, he often advised them that do not get married a smart girl. And one of the juniors asked him why do we need not meet the smart girl? He said, when I have an argument with my wife, she said, what was your score of the university entrance test? I got higher score than you. She opens, say, this score. When he hears that, he could not argue her anymore. She makes him to discourage. So, she does not want to him to arguments anymore. So, he doesn't want to speak about it. That's why he speaks to his school juniors. The worst things about the arguments is the religions. Psalms 3, verse 2. Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. The evils say that God leaves you alone. This is the temptations by the evil. The words makes you get down. We having this service on the first week of a new year.
부르짖음이라는 거예요.
Some of you already got down.
3절 4절 보십시오. 여호와여 주는 나의 방패시요 나의
The most important thing we need to remember is that we need to cry out. Psalms 3, verses 3 to 4. But you are a shield around me, O Lord. You bestow glory on me and lift up my head. To the Lord I cry aloud, and he answers me from his holy hills. The word doesn't help you to be saved. From these verses, the things we need to remember, you are a shield around me. Our God protects us from the enemies. The specific verse is 3. The verse 3 is the response of the verse 2. The words makes your judgments about you. Someone say to you, you are ugly person. But you don't have to get the answers from the person signing. Someone say that you become alone. No one likes you. But do not think about what they said. The word said, you cannot be saved, but you must know our God already saved you. What we need to do, we need to cry out to the Lord. From the Bible, when you cry out, our God said, this is your righteousness. We know the names Abel and Cain. Cain killed Abel, both provided God with their belongings. Genesis chapter 4, verse 1, the Lord said, what have you done? Listen, your brother's blood cries out to me from the ground. When you cry out, it makes you a face. A prodigal son was away from his father, but the son comes to his father from his trouble. A child cries out to the parents. When the child cries out, the parents listen to what the son says. When you come to God, you need to cry out. And this means that I do not have any righteousness to show you. I talked about the prodigal sons. Actually, he was proud of himself. So, with his father's wealth, he was proud of his living. However, through troubles, the sons returned to his father. Last month, I preached about Habakkuk. This advises that Aladdin asked Jasmine about his face. Aladdin asked her, do you trust me? And she said, yes. In church, many church members become weaker and they like to judge others. When you have problems, you need to cry out, and also you build a trust with God. We can see some stories from the Bible. To begin with, Genesis chapter 32 shows that Jacob wrestles with God. In the words of Hebrews, wrestling means crying out with our body. So we need to focus on the words of the wrestles. Our God likes to listen to us. And also, he tries to make you get bothered. Some people think that I am stronger than God. And they like to wrestle with God. However, we need to trust God. We already knew that our God is much stronger than us. From the Bible, it says, Exodus chapter 32, verse 23, they say to me, make us gods who will go before us. As for this fellow, it's Moses who brought us up out of Egypt. We do not know what was happened to him. The period of Judges is significant. This time, the Israelites cry out the Lord. The stories in Judges shows that the Israelites cry out without any message. Judges chapter 3, verse 9, but when they cried out to the Lord, He raised up from them a deliverer. From this verse, we need to think about that we just do cry out without anything. We need to cry out. This is the important message to remember. From today's verses, we need to think about David. What he has done, he just cried out. Psalms 4, and Psalms 5, all of shows that David cried out. Psalms 5, verse 2, listen to my cry for help, my King and my God, for to you I pray. 1 Samuel chapter 30, the Amalekites carried women and children off as the Amalekites went on their way. David and his men were allowed, but David formed strength in the Lord his God. Jesus predicted that Peter would deny Jesus 3 times before the rooster crows. Peter said, even if I have to die with you, I will never disown you. However, he disowned Jesus 3 times as what Jesus said. Matthew chapter 27, verse 75, Peter remembered the words Jesus had spoken. Before the rooster crows, you will disown me 3 times. And he went outside and wept bitterly. When you cry out, you become honest. So what you need to do, you just cry out. And also, you're trying to show yourself to win with honest. All of us become downed, but with God, we'll get bothered. Some people have disconnections with God. We need to create our lives. And this time, we feel like becoming happiness. And we need to think about our lives without righteousness. There are some groups that people in the groups like to show their pride to others. And in the church, some of them show their wealth, and they're trying to be the leaders in the group. And also, they're trying to become calm because they show themselves with coverings themselves. Some of them have some troubles with the covers of themselves. For me, when I make a plans for tours, it is difficult for me to make a great plan. So I like the package tourings with my family. I like to give everything to a specialist. I do not want to carry the heavy things on me. Some people have some disconnections with others. So they become tired in their lives. Some people have lost their wild. And also they trying to control themselves. Some people cannot control themselves, but with the coverings, they tend to cover from others. However, this attitude comes from the evil. They're trying to go into the narrow light. And also, they're trying to make their own kingdom. So it shows the opposites of the gospel. We need to think about the gospels is inclusive, not exclusive. So we need to go into the broad gospel. But some of them cannot do it because they're trying to stay in their boundary. So they have lost their specific talent. I'll give you one example. Birds have a specific characteristic. When they get out of their eggs, as they see the things first, they think it is a mother. There was an eagle, and eagles came out of the eggs, and when the eagles opened eyes, he found that a chicken, and the eagle saw that it is my mother. Chicks like to have earthworms to eat. The eagle hits the ground and he finds 10 earthworms. One day, the eagle looks up the sky and there are a few eagles flying in the sky. However, the eagle doesn't even notice his identity as a flying one. Do not worry about your light. Do not worry about what you eat, what to wear, where to live. Our God has already known what you need. In Korea, no one gets died with starving because the public officials help you to have food. In our lives, we have enough, but they like to have more. That's why they worry about their life to have more things. But some of them are trying to think about their life to have more. What we need to do, we need to cry out. We need to think about some message, how to cry out. I'm a pastor, so I have watched some movies to get messages relating to Bible. I want to talk about one movie, The Dead Poets in the Society. I want to talk about the messages from the movie. I want to talk about some characteristics. The person is a teacher. His name is John Keady, who is characterized by Robin Williams. He teaches in the good university. In his class, there is a student. His name is Todd Anderson. He is the main character. to describe his background, Todd's brother is famous of the best students in the school. Everyone calls Todd as his younger brother. So Todd has discouragement from his brother. And also, he couldn't assure himself in the school because he doesn't want to comparisons between himself and his brother. One day, the teacher calls him to read a part, but he's not able to read from his lost confidence. Suddenly, the teacher said, "Shout to me." And to describe situations. And also, some people said, barbarians yell out. And also, like the barbarians, you need to shout. And you need to shout from your internal mind. I give you one example to describe. Some Catholic church, from this church, the church members like to cry out. They called Jesus, the name of Jesus, three times, which is like prayer. But some people say this is the Korean style prayer. I think you need to cry out when you have some troubles. I like to talk about one Korean movies. I think this is the stories about the church members. The name of the movie is Mil-young, and the main character's name is Shin-e. From the stories, it was an addictions case. An addictions kills a boy. He was caught and sent to the prison. The dead boy's mother visited the prison to see him, and the man said, "Jesus helps me to be saved from my life." And the main character, Shin-e, got angry from what the man said. And she said, "Why, Lord, what have you done to the man?" And also, she was crying out from her mind. I think she needs to cry out more, and we need to this stage like her. You need to yell out. I think from the Bible, many people cry out when they are in trouble. And we need to ask the Lord, "Why, Lord, what are you doing this time?" And also, you need to look at my light to describe the words makes you to suitable to the word. And also, some people did not listen to what God said. Church is the connections between the earth and the heaven. We need to cry out. In the church, when you praise the Lord, this is kind of prayer. I think some people who need to pray, you need to sing a song. Our church like to praise the Lord. When you prayed a lot, you're trying to find your identity.
원래 기도를 오래 하면 깨집니다 그거. 그때 그 깨지는
When you prayed, you do not want to think about your troubles anymore. And also you trying to cry out to the Lord. In our church, when you pray, we trying to dance to the Lord. This is like the wrestling with God. I think most church must to make the connections between the heaven and church members. We need to make connected to the Lord. And also, we make open our lives from the trouble. The evils tempt you to close and make these connections from others. And some people do not want to speak anymore. And also, the words makes you get down. However, this is a temptation from the evil. We need to wrestle with God. What is the result when you cry out? Psalms 3, verse 5. I lie down and sleep. I wake up again because the Lord sustains me. Taking my personal experiences, when I was a high school student, I was 108 centimeters tall. The height of buses was 180 centimeters. My head reached on the top of the bus. My mom's worried about my tall, so she bought a weight. I open lift the weight with 6 kilograms. From the time my toe stopped it, and also my shoulders become wider. Also, I thought about how I grew taller. I always see it, especially I like to eat seaweed. And also, the seaweed is salty. With it, I ate a lot of dish of rice. When I was young, I ate a lot. I think it helped me to grow up. And also, especially in school vacations, I slept for a long time. I slept a few hours. Every day, I'm trying to sleep enough. So it makes me grow up taller. I thought when I woke up, I grow up with 20 centimeters taller. I think some people who do not taller need to sleep well. Like this verse, Psalms 3 verse 5, the Bible says, I lie down and sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustain me. Mark chapter 4 verse 27, night and day, whether he sleeps or gets up, the seed sprouts and grows, though he does not know how. I'll give you an example. There is a couple. On driving, in the car, a woman keeps speaking about his driving. The man doesn't want to listen to what she says. She doesn't want to she speaks anymore. But when she sleeps without any saying, the man thinks that she's in comfort. Also, she thinks that I'm trying to take care of her. Both thinks different way. The woman keeps speaking because she worries about his driving. However, in the opposite of the situations, when she becomes silent, this means that she doesn't want to speak anymore because she is not interested of him. Psalm 3, verse 6, I will not fear the tens of thousands draw up against me on every side. When you have relieved from your face, you will become stronger and you will not fear from the enemy. Some people faced all fears and also they struggle with the enemy. And they opened, look up others. But this child, we need to speak that, here I am. My Lord, please send me. I want to talk about a person. His name is Nietzsche Preach. Who is an atheist. What he said, you sailed your boat on an uninducated mat. He said, a life is an adventure. In our lives, everyone has trouble. They could not get out of their troubles. They must face the world. Some people say there are some quiet places, like Norway and also distant countries. But I think all places are dangerous. And give more examples. Some parents say when you study harder, you couldn't have any troubles in the future. But the parents say you must study harder. However, it is wrong. When the children grow up, there are more troubles. Some people say you cannot face the fear when you work harder. However, everyone has troubles. People must build up their while. The last point is that Psalm 3, verse 7. Arise, O Lord, deliver me, O my God. Strike all my enemies on the jaw, break the teeth of the wicked. From this verse, the verse focus on strike all my enemies on the jaw, break the teeth of the wicked. When you cry out, you become honest and trying to show yourself. I want to talk about the one pastor who delivered the couple's love. And the pastor said, he talked about his son's experiences. His son's broke up his girlfriend. From the time, the son could not eat any food for 50 days. And the son said, I am sick because I could not see her anymore. She imagined that when I go into a cafe, I remember the days when I was with her. I miss her so much. The son remembered the memories when he was with her ex-girlfriend. The pastor said, you need to speak more. But the son said, I couldn't speak even one word. He becomes honest. And the pastor believed that what the son said. We need to build up trust. What you need to do, you need to cry out. And also, you need to show yourself to the Lord. The last point is that Psalm 3, verse 8, from the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessings be on your people. The disperse mentions that the victory belongs to the Lord. And also, please, all blessings to the people. The gospel makes you become broader, and also you get bolder. The word makes you get down. But when you cry out, you think about wider light. To summarize, the word makes you get down. However, this time you need to cry out. You need to praise. You need to pray. And you make a connections with the Lord. Our God gives you comfort. And also, you will become rise up. Also, you will build up the trust. And lastly, you will become bolder. This year, you received a great victory from the Lord. Please stand up and we sing a song.